learning abilities. These behaviors keep our whales active and engaged. SeaWorld's killer whales have inspired generations of our guests to care about our natural world, and we're excited to share their story with you today.
Killer whales are the ocean's top predator. They use cooperation and communication, not just size and strength, to take their place at the top of the ocean's food chain. At the bottom are small animals, like krill. At the top, the apex predator, the killer whale. Killer whales are as big as a bus, faster than an Olympic swimmer.
We're going to see all that and more. These behaviors contribute to an environment that is full of enrichment.
We spend days, weeks, months, years building relationships with our whales. This creates trust, and that allows us to do some amazing things. For example, when you visit the doctor, you present your arm to draw blood, or step on the scale to see how much you weigh. It's much the same with our whales.
Today, we'll see the whales moving together, in unison. These synchronized behaviors strengthen social bonds and enable them to problem solve as a group. Working together as a team makes them the ocean's top predator. Scientifically known as Orcinus orca, but commonly referred to as killer whales, here at SeaWorld, we like to call them Katina, Nalani, Malia, Trua, and Makaio, our killer whale family. Makaio is our youngest whale at just 13 years of age, and our oldest whale is Makaio's mother, Katina, who this year celebrated her 48th birthday. Katina is also the matriarch, the leader of our pod. SeaWorld's animal training techniques create a language between us and the whales. It's a language of learning through positive reinforcement, encouragement, commitment, and care. Through these techniques and our relationships, the whales learn to trust us. They even learn to take an active role in their very own health and well-being. One of the first healthcare or husbandry behaviors that we train is a position in which we would ask for a voluntary blood sample. The whales learn to roll ventral or upside down and present us with their tail flukes. Not only does this give us a great view of their entire body, but it also gives us access to blood vessels that are easily seen on the white undersides of these tail flukes. Our veterinarians will collect the blood sample at least once a month, and the whales are trained to remain calm and relaxed throughout the procedure. As trainers, you'll commonly see us rubbing down or massaging the whales, whether on their backs, their pectoral flippers, or those tail flukes. The whales have very sensitive skin, and this is just one way that we can reward them for remaining calm during procedures like this. It's also a great way for us to strengthen our relationships with the whales. Another important diagnostic is weighing the whales. And we're able to weigh the whales by asking them to slide their bodies out of the water but onto a giant killer whale-sized scale located in one of our adjacent pools. And when a whale slides out of the water, you'll notice that a portion of their body from the dorsal fin to the tail flukes remains in the water. That's called the panuncle. It's the powerhouse of the killer whale. It's very muscular and very heavy. In fact, natural athletic behavior that we see in all killer whales is the ability to lift that portion of their body with such force that they can completely turn before re-entering the water. So in a scenario like this, with Malia and Morgan up here, in order to get an accurate weight of our killer whales, we simply ask them to raise that tail portion up out of the water. Turning this posture ensures accuracy, so we know our younger whales are growing properly and that our older whales are maintaining a healthy weight.
And the care isn't just physical. Mental stimulation and play are vital, and we surprise and engage with our whales at every opportunity. Play is how killer whales teach their young to hunt. For the adults, play is important too. It seems that they just enjoy having fun. Making time for play is an important part of life for killer whales and for us.
Hey everybody, we're over on the left side of the stadium down by the glass. We just learned that killer whales love to play, but did you know that they actually learn a lot by playing and through observational learning and mimicry? And we're going to put that to the test with our matriarch, Katina, and everybody here on the left side of the stadium. So, if you guys would like to participate and help us out, stay right where you are, but just stand up. We're gonna play a little game of killer whale follow the leader, and you guys are the leaders. So, on the count of three, all we need you to do is keep your arms to your sides and spin in a circle two times. Ready? One, two, three. Everybody spin! She's watching, and she's got it! Great job, everybody! Thank you so much. You guys can have a seat. As you can see, Katina was paying very close attention to you guys. Killer whales have great eyesight both below and above the water, and can often be seen jumping completely out of the water to get a better look around. Malia's gonna demonstrate with a behavior we call a bow. When you see her, give her a great big cheer!
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoy.